Welcome back to Comic Book Historians. I'm Alex Grant. Go to click on that juicy red subscribe button down below. And don't forget to check out my book, Understanding Superhero Comic Books. Today we're talking about the medium of comics and film, their early origins, what they have in common, and one key critical thing they have differently. At the onset of the 20th century, two key events forever changed the landscape of global entertainment. The births of both the American film and comic book industries. As these fledgling sectors spread their wings, they dealt with legal issues, distribution and production obstacles, and concerns over morality and censorship. Trailblazers such as Harry Donenfeld, Jack Liebowitz, Thomas Edison, and the Warner siblings were not merely witnesses to this unfolding drama, but also its influential authors, sculpting an enduring narrative that continues to influence these industries' trajectories. In the theater of the film industry, no figure cast a longer shadow in its early days than Thomas Edison. Utilizing his impressive array of filmmaking patents, he co-founded the Motion Picture Patents Company in 1908, a body that wielded such power it forced many independent filmmakers to seek refuge in Hollywood, California. Hollywood has favorable weather, diverse countryside locales, and a large physical distance from Edison, who was based in the East Coast. In this new promised land, ambitious players like Metro Pictures, Goodman Pictures, and Louis B. Mayer Productions joined forces, giving birth to the cinematic powerhouse Metro-Goldwyn and Mayer in 1924. Meanwhile, Warner Brothers, conceived in 1923 by the visionary Warner siblings, upended industry conventions by introducing synchronizing sound in The Jazz Singer in 1927, forever altering the way stories were told on the silver screen. Yet the industry's progress was far from untroubled. A cascade of public scandals and rising concerns over the content of films necessitated the institution of the Hays Code in the early 1930s. The Hays Code, initiated by Motion Picture Producers and Distributors of America's Will Hays in 1930, was a self-regulated moral guide for Hollywood films, established in response to public outcry over perceived obscenity. It was adopted by the industry to prevent government regulation and effectively dictated movie content through financial leverage, as non-compliant films risked losing distribution, reigning until supplanted by the MPAA rating system in 1968. Two examples were at the forefront of this discussion: the Fatty Arbuckle scandal in 1921, Roscoe Arbuckle, a popular comedic actor and one of the highest paid stars in Hollywood, was accused of the rape and murder of actress Virginia Rapp. After a series of trials, Arbuckle was acquitted, but the scandal irreparably damaged his career and led to the public questioning the morality of Hollywood. The next controversy was The Docks of New York in 1928. This silent film, directed by Joseph von Sternberg, told the story of a rough-and-tumble stoker who falls in love with a suicidal dance hall girl. Its grim depiction of the waterfront underworld and themes of promiscuity, crime, and suicide drew moral outrage from certain quarters. The censorship code attempted to rein in perceived excesses and moral improprieties, setting a new benchmark for cinematic content. During this era of questionable morality, Hollywood was utilizing exploitative contracts for its talent, leading to the formation of labor unions such as the Screen Actors Guild, the Writers Guild of America, and the Directors Guild of America. These unions heralded a significant evolution within the industry, advocating for workers' rights, fair remuneration, reasonable working conditions, and creative control. They challenged the dominant authority of the film studios, ushering in a new era of balanced power. As the film industry began to solidify its foundations, a parallel narrative was unfolding within the American comic book industry in the 1930s and 1940s. Visionaries like Malcolm Wheeler-Nicholson, founder of DC Comics, and Martin Goodman, the future originator of Marvel Comics, were instrumental in laying the groundwork of genre-specific pulps and comic books. However, the entrance of Harry Donenfeld and Jack Liebowitz marked a seismic shift within the industry. By subverting Wheeler-Nicholson's ownership by dubiously pushing him out while investing in DC Comics in the late 1930s, they catapulted the superhero genre to center stage with the introduction of timeless characters such as Superman and Batman. This genre choice ushered in a new era of viability and stability for the comic book industry. Yet the talented creators enabling this were deprived of basic healthcare and pensions and eventually relegated to freelancer status. The comic book industry, unlike its film counterpart, experienced considerable setbacks in its attempt to unionize. These endeavors by Arnold Drake and John Broome, and later Neil Adams, to create a comic book labor union were met with staunch resistance by Leibowitz, resulting in some of their departures from DC Comics. A new generation of writers and artists entered the field who were former fans happy to work on superhero comic books without benefits. This failed unionization effort left an indelible mark on the comic book industry, which is still felt to this current day. Much like the film industry, the comic book world also found itself wrestling with a moral quandary. Their covers were adorned with acts of sex and violence to promote sales to the point that comics were accused of fueling juvenile delinquency, leading to the formation of the Comics Code Authority in 1954. This body established a set of guidelines reminiscent of Hollywood's Hays Code, which sought to instill a moral compass within comic book narratives. In a fascinating confluence of histories, Warner Brothers and DC Comics, despite their starkly contrasting backgrounds concerning worker rights, were brought together in 1969. This occurred when the Kinney National Company, parent entity of Warner Brothers, acquired DC Comics. This merger marked a pivotal moment as it facilitated the cross-pollination of ideas, with comic book narratives being successfully adapted into films and vice versa, forever blurring the lines between these two media, and making these comic book films that we see today possible. The tumultuous yet triumphant journey of the film and comic book industries have left an imprint on our cultural fabric. Their narratives are not merely tales of industries, but of resilience, innovation, and the power of collective action. The early struggles, from patent wars to the birth of Hollywood and the institution of censorship codes, have shaped how we produce, consume, and perceive popular culture today. The success of labor unions within the film industry and the failed unionization attempts within the comic book industry highlight the complex interplay between power dynamics and creative rights. The personal narratives of industry giants like Thomas Edison, the Warner siblings, Malcolm Wheeler-Nicholson, Martin Goodman, Harry Donenfeld, and Jack Leibowitz provide a human face to these historical transformations. Their trials, triumphs, and tenacity help shape industry norms and continue to inspire new generations of creatives. Today, we can trace the enduring legacies of these trailblazers in the continued popularity of films and comic books, the dominance of the superhero genre, and the rise of transmedia franchises. By understanding these intertwined histories, we can better comprehend the co-evolution of these two media and further anticipate how they can continue to redefine the media landscape of the future.